Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. This video describes the recently approved drug palovarotene sold under the brand name of SOHONOS. This video emphasizes the MedChem properties of the drug rather than the compound's clinical pharmacology. If you are, by chance, a scientist who worked on this project and are able to speak about this research or your general work at Ipsen, I would be very interested in interviewing you for a separate video. The channel email address is in the video description. Palovarotene was approved by the FDA on the 16th of August in 2023. The drug had already been approved for use in Canada. The active pharmaceutical ingredient is palovarotene, which is the U.S. adopted name. The branded name of the drug is SOHONOS, and that is in all caps. Palovarotene is administered once a day, orally, and the typical dose is 5 milligrams, with adjustments for patient mass and higher doses possible in certain situations. Palovarotene has two indications. One is heterotopic ossification, and the other is fibrodysplasia ossificans progressiva. Ipsen sponsored the NDA. All this information can be found through the drug's prescribing information through the link at the bottom of the screen. Let's discuss palovarotene's indications. The first is heterotopic ossification, HO. This condition involves the formation of extraskeletal bone in muscle and other soft tissues. The bone tissue is often formed in response to some form of trauma, such as from burns or surgery. The second indication for palovarotene is fibrodysplasia ossificans progressiva, FOP. FOP is a genetic variation of heterotopic ossification, in which ossification can be either from trauma or occur spontaneously. FOP is often first diagnosed based on deformations in the joint of the big toe of young children, with more aggressive ossification starting by the age of 10. The life expectancy for FOP patients is only about 40 years. FOP is a very rare condition, with likely under 1,000 patients globally. Palovarotene is the first approved treatment for FOP. Palovarotene's mechanism of action is agonism of retinoic acid receptor gamma. This is a nuclear receptor. Nuclear receptors are considered transcription factors for gene expression. So ligands for nuclear receptors, including retinoic acid receptor gamma, can have broad and powerful effects. Without going into all the pathways, which candidly I do not understand, palovarotene, through its agonism of retinoic acid receptor gamma, suppresses the formation of cartilage and bone. Ligands for retinoic acid receptor gamma are not new. So in the upper left, we have retinoic acid, the endogenous ligand for the receptor. In the lower left is palovarotene, the star of this video. Other reported retinoic acid receptor gamma agonists include BMS-270394, which is not a drug, and tamibarotene. All these compounds bind retinoic acid receptor gamma. Retinoic acid, palovarotene, and the BMS compound are selective for the gamma isoform. Tamibarotene is actually selective for retinoic acid receptor alpha. You can see from these compounds that they all certainly have striking structural similarities. And achieving selectivity for one isoform over another is challenging. With all these compounds, as well as others not shown, being retinoic acid receptor gamma agonists, one might wonder what makes palovarotene distinctive. Well, most of the gamma-selective ligands have been designed for topical use, often for acne. Palovarotene is an orally available compound and provides systemic exposure of the drug. Let's look at palovarotene's physicochemical properties. Based on palovarotene's properties, we can see that it does fit the profile of an oral drug. The molecular weight is low. The numbers of hydrogen bond donors and hydrogen bond acceptors are also low. The lipophilicity is somewhat high, but it's the only red flag from among the properties here. All these properties, aside from perhaps lipophilicity, are consistent with a compound with reasonable membrane permeability, which is critical for an orally administered drug. Keep in mind that palovarotene must not only cross the membranes in the lining of the GI tract, but it must also enter cells to reach its target, as nuclear receptors are only found within cells. The on-target potency of palovarotene has not been reported. X-ray structures of palovarotene have also not been reported. There are, however, published X-ray structures of retinoic acid receptor gamma co-crystallized with retinoic acid analogs. Here is a screenshot from a protein databank entry for a retinoic acid receptor gamma co-crystal that was used to develop trifarotene, a topical acne drug. So while no co-crystal for palovarotene has been recorded, the scientists at Ipsen likely had access to adequate structural information on ligand-target interactions to facilitate the discovery program. Of course, these data would be valuable, not only for improving potency, but also tuning selectivity for the gamma isoform. Here are the key PK parameters for palovarotene. The half-life is 8.7 hours, which is a very typical value for a once-daily oral drug. The clearance and volume of distribution are consistent with the reported half-life. You can always manually check these values. The relationship between half-life and volume of distribution and clearance is shown. If you use these values for clearance and volume of distribution, then you get a half-life of 9.5 hours. Mathematically, 9.5 hours is not the same as 8.7 hours, but physiologically, these values are essentially the same. So all these data look good. The bioavailability for palovarotene is unknown. The bioavailability is almost certainly known for some preclinical animal species, but has perhaps not been studied in humans yet. Plasma protein binding is high. Renal excretion is not explicitly reported in the prescribing information. In a mass balance study, only 3% of the drug was observed in the urine, and the text is unclear on whether the material observed in the urine was the parent drug or metabolites. In either case, the unchanged renal excretion is quite low. Over 95% of the drug is excreted in the feces, so biliary excretion is likely the primary route of excretion. Here are the reported metabolites for palovarotene. I like these structures because I find them surprising. When looking at the structure of palovarotene, I would have guessed that the metabolism would occur on one of the aromatic rings, likely the pyrazole ring, or perhaps the alkene would undergo an oxidation. Instead, all the metabolites involve CH oxidation of seemingly unactivated positions on the drug. These carbons are carbon 6 and carbon 7 as the sites of reaction. Drug metabolism is often quite predictable, but not always. These metabolites primarily arise from the action of cytochrome 3A4 with smaller contributions from 2C19 and 2C8. The 2C8 isoform is infrequently active in drug metabolism. In terms of safety, palovarotene does carry a boxed warning, and both severe safety risks are directly related to the drug's mode of action. Palovarotene can cause closure of the epiphyseal plate, the growth plate found at the end of long bones. Palovarotene can be dosed in girls as young as 8 years of age and boys as young as 10. These patients are likely not fully grown, and palovarotene can stunt their skeletal growth. Palovarotene also shows embryo-fetal toxicity, which is not surprising. Female patients taking palovarotene must take precautions against becoming pregnant. Palovarotene does carry other risks as well. In total, these safety risks may seem severe, but the benefits of palovarotene have been judged to outweigh these risks by the US FDA, given the severity of FOP. The drug, however, has yet to be approved in Europe at the time of this video. those are some highlights for palovarotene, marketed as SOHONOS by Ipsen Biopharmaceuticals. Palovarotene is approved by the FDA for the treatment of heterotopic ossification and fibrodysplasia ossificans progressiva. Of the two indications, media coverage and press releases on the approval tend to focus on treatment of fibrodysplasia ossificans progressiva, so perhaps that is the primary indication of the drug. Palovarotene acts as a selective retinoic acid receptor agonist and suppresses bone tissue formation. Thank you for watching, and I appreciate your time and attention. I hope you enjoyed this discussion of the approval of palovarotene. Please consider subscribing to the channel, leaving a like, or making a comment. Take care.